Hi, Luis. It's a pleasure to interview you about the publication that you have co-authored of Territorial and Sustainable Healthy Diets.
Thank you, Margarita. It is also a pleasure for me to share the knowledge we just published.
Excellent. One of the major challenges of our time is malnutrition in all its forms: undernutrition, micronutrient deficiencies, overweight, and obesity. Unhealthy diets top the list of the main risk factors for the global burden of disease. And there is also the degradation of natural resources and the environment. Luis, you have done research in this area. Can you let us know a bit more about this situation?
Yes, in fact, both malnutrition by deficiency and overweight and obesity are very frequent conditions all over the world. But what is new is that currently obesity is more prevalent than malnutrition in all the geographical areas in the world. So this is something that appeared in the recent years. Yeah. And the paper we just published is the result of some discussions we had in a consultancy organized by WHO and FAO in July 2019. At that time, we discussed the dietary patterns that are healthy and that are sustainable. And in particular, we discussed the role of traditional diets as models to recommend the population dietary patterns that are healthy and sustainable.
Excellent. And at the global level, food production accounts for the use of 48% and 70% of land and fresh water resources, respectively. And research shows that different types of diets contribute to greenhouse gas emissions differently. In your article, the Mediterranean diet and the New Nordic diet, the so-called territorial diets, are becoming increasingly interesting for this catalytic role, especially within the context of sustainable development goals. Can you let us know a bit more about these diets?
Yes, both the Mediterranean diet and the New Nordic diet are considered healthy and with a low environmental impact. But Mediterranean diet and the New Nordic diet are different. The Mediterranean diet is a traditional diet of Mediterranean countries that was described in the 1960s in the island of Crete. Yeah. And the New Nordic diet is a diet that was recently designed by scientists and different stakeholders in the Nordic countries based on traditional habits in these countries, but also adapting it to the new situation. In general, we can consider that the majority of the traditional diets in the different geographical regions in the world are healthy and sustainable, because in general they are based on plant foods with limited consumption of animal foods that have a higher environmental impact than the plant foods.
Yeah. The relationship between diets and sustainability goes back to the late 1980s, when the case was made for the need to consider environmental concerns and the protection of natural resources in dietary guidelines. How has evolved this relationship in the recent years?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I would say that at the level of the scientists and also the population, we are more and more conscious of the relevance of consuming some foods or other different foods, not only in terms of health, but also in terms of sustainability. So yeah, this is one evolution. In the recent decades, there was much more research on the health effects of the diets. For example, this is the case for the Mediterranean diet, and less on the environmental impact. However, in the very recent years, the research on the effects of environmental effects of the different dietary patterns increase. So we know much better now what is the impact of the consumption of the different types of foods. And yeah, this is important in order to to give recommendations for the population.
Excellent. The adherence to the Mediterranean diet is decreasing in the Mediterranean region. Why do you think this is happening?
Yes, the Mediterranean diet was described at a time that the traditional and local Mediterranean foods were the majority and were easily available. However, from that time, there are more and more availability of processed food with a high content of energy, of saturated fat, of salt, and also free sugars. Yeah. And these foods are very palatable. People like to eat them because the taste, the positive characteristics in the terms of taste, and also the low price. So all the, let's say, ingredients of these foods promote the consumption, especially in those families having a low socioeconomic status because the price and low education or nutritional education.
Excellent. And what would be your recommendation for a better adherence to these territorial diets?
Yes. In the Mediterranean region, we have a lot of research, and this is widely accepted that our dietary pattern is very good for health and for sustainability. We should make an effort in order to promote the local food, the seasonal foods, the types of cooking also that are important. But potential in the Mediterranean area is relatively, or should be relatively easy, no? But in other geographical regions, probably we should, or they should promote the traditional local diet that in general is based in plant foods, but improving it and suggesting also the consumption of limited amounts of animal products.
Excellent. And Luis, what is the link between territorial diets and flexitarian diets?
Yes, the flexitarian diets is a new concept recommending diets based mainly in plant foods, but with very limited amounts of animal foods. In general, traditional diets are flexitarian diets, mm-hmm. because the basis of the dietary pattern used to be plant foods. Also, again, with limited amounts of animal foods. But I am in favor of using the traditional names, the Mediterranean diet, or the Japanese diet, or the Brazilian diet, because they are based on the local products of each country, and in general, with the consumption of limited amounts of animal foods.
Okay. And to finish, Luis, what are the key takeaway messages from the review paper? I mean, what are the do's and don'ts in a practical approach for dietitians, policymakers, etc.?
In fact, the main difference in between the recent recommendations in general for the population is to consume in general a pattern of alimentation based on cereal products, legumes, fruits, vegetables in general, and less animal products. Probably the main difference from the recent recommendations would be to decrease a little bit more the animal foods in relation to what was in the recommendations available in the majority of the countries. But in my opinion, there is still a need for some research to precise the optimal amount of animal foods in a recommended dietary patterns to balance the health effects and the environmental impact, because animal foods contribute to the consumption of some vitamins and minerals that are important, and for example, to maintain adequate consumption of vitamin 12, folate, calcium, it's almost compulsory to consume meat and also dairy products.
Okay. So thank you very much for your time, Luis.
Thank you, Margarita.